Hello, we're back again, and in case you haven't been with us, we'd like to remind you that it's the Ralph Emery Show, and I'm Susan Raye, along with Ralph, we'll be with you for the next few moments.
And our show is presented by...
By Bayer Aspirin.
And
Ford Trucks.
Very good, Susan.
Thank you.
Susan, we welcome you back. And we're delighted that you could spend some more time with us before you jump on an airplane and go back to California. Now, to open the show from a new album produced by Johnny Cash and performed by Bob Lumen, here's Bob doing an old Johnny, the very first Johnny Cash hit. And it was called Hey Porter.
Hey Porter, hey Porter, would you tell me the time? How much longer will it be till we cross that Mason-Dixon line? At daylight, will you tell that engineer to slow it down? Or better still, just stop the train, 'cause I want to look around. Hey Porter, hey Porter, what time did you say? How much longer will it be till I can see the light of day? When we hit Dixie, will you tell that engineer to ring his bell? And ask everybody that ain't asleep to stand right up and yell. It's getting light outside. This old train is a puffing smoke and I have to strain my eyes. But ask that engineer if he will blow his whistle, please. 'Cause I smell frost on cotton leaves and I smell that southern breeze. Hey Porter, please open up my door. When they stop this train, I'm gonna get off first, 'cause I can't wait no more. Tell that engineer, says thanks a lot, and I didn't mind the fare. I'm gonna set my feet on southern soil and breathe that southern air.
That's Bob Lumen's interpretation of the first Johnny Cash hit, Hey Porter. And now here's a word about a nifty 150, the new 77 Ford F-150 pickup truck. You own a ranch or farm or just want a smart-looking pickup to tool around town in? Ford's got your number, F-150, a tough truck made even tougher this year. New high-efficiency V8s designed for extra reliability. New anti-corrosion measures that include fender liners front and rear. New low-schedule maintenance needs and more. You can choose from two-wheel drive or 4x4s that make their own roads and run on any kind of gas, regular, premium, or unleaded. Have a big crowd to tote around? Then maybe you want an extra roomy F-150 workhorse, that family-size Ford Super Cab, America's roomiest two-door pickup. Whatever you pick, you've got yourself one tough truck. Just how tough? Well, 93 out of 100 of all Ford trucks registered over the last 12 years are still on the job. So get yourself down to your Ford dealer and check out that F-150. It's the huskiest half-ton Ford has ever built. We are talking with Susan Raye, and Susan, I think we'll just launch into a little song here before we talk about anything else. I would rather you talk about this song, okay?
All right. This is a song that was written in part by Bonnie Guitar.
And golly, I haven't heard of Bonnie Guitar in years.
Right. And she had written it, and I tried to record it earlier, and we couldn't get it from the publishing. And then about a year or two later, we found out that we could get it, so we recorded it. It's called The Cheating Game.
Break a heart, then laugh and walk away. Of true love, you've made a mockery. Free to go, knowing next time you'll pay no price for your common vice. The cheating game. Love and lies go hand in hand. Your love goes free like wind-blown sand. Seeking out unwary prey, teaching them the way you play the cheating game. Who knows the mind of the cheating kind? Who's blocked the shadows from sight? Who's gonna pay the price to make the wrong seem right? You're gonna go scot-free to live a life without blame, while I reap the harvest of heartaches from the cheating game. You planted the seed, now I must sow my love alone to make it grow, carrying the only thing you left me, a legacy from the cheating game. The web of dreams you weaved so well was casting the die for my private self, taking love, forsaking love, making me a victim of the cheating game. Who knows the mind of the cheating kind? Who's blocked the shadows from sight? Who's gonna pay the price to make the wrong seem right? You're gonna go scot-free to live a life without blame, while I reap the harvest of heartaches from the cheating game.
Susan, what has happened to Bonnie Guitar, who co-wrote that song?
I believe she's living up around Seattle. She has a farm and spends a great deal of time up there.
Isn't she a horse rancher?
Yes.
I've heard that she is. And near Orting, Washington. Now it comes back to me.
Where?
Orting.
I've never heard of it.
O-R-T-I-N-G.
Really? Hmm.
Check that out.
That's a new one.
You've heard our guest Susan Raye sing Cheatin' Game. You know, I told you in an earlier show, I said something to you that was wrong. I said I had never been hit in the face with a pie. I'd forgotten.
And I just hit him in the face with one.
I spent one afternoon being hit in the face with a pie, repeatedly, for television. And we were cutting the opening for the Three Stooges series. And these pies were really made up of soap.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
that's what...
Pie pan with soap.
Shaving cream.
Yeah.
Yes.
And they'd hit me in the face with it, and I'd hear somebody yell, "Cut!" And I think they really got to putting me on, you
yes.
know.
Yes. Well, what amazes me is how anybody could be hit in the face with a pie repeatedly and not recall.
I must have been hit 15 times. I had a tie on, it ruined the tie. It got so soapy. But that was a great day in my life.
Oh, I bet.
Now, we were talking earlier about practical jokes pulled on you. Did you ever, in turn, pull practical jokes on anybody else?
Well, yes.
What'd you do?
As a matter of fact, I put together a pie of my own while we were in Las Vegas. The last night that we were there, it was just kind of in Vegas, they kind of pull practical jokes the last night that you're on a show. And first of all, I went out on stage with a long fancy dress on that had feathers all over it or something, and I wore a pair of two different pairs of striped wild socks underneath, and I came out and did a little dance during one of the songs. And then I also got a pie ready, and we thought it would be funny to throw it in Doyle Singer's face.
Now, he's another one of the buckaroos.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Everyone else thought it was funny, but Doyle wasn't too amused.
He get mad?
He got very angry.
Then this was your practical joke.
Well, it wasn't my idea, but I made the pie that went in his face.
Is it a real pie?
No, it was shaving cream.
Oh, okay.
And he said it stung.
Did you apologize?
Yeah, a week later when he talked to us again.
Oh. I was listening to the latest album by Johnny Cash, and I got a big kick out of this record that we're about to play. I think this is cute. John R. wrote the song, and it's called City Jail.
I was hanging around a bus station cafe there, minding my own business, like I always do. And I thought I'd check out the action, like I always do. And I gave this waitress the big eye and I made a few choice personal comments about what I thought mine and her possibilities could be for a team when she called the badge on me. The badge grabbed me by the arm and said, "Hey boy, what are you hanging around here for?" And I said, "Well, whatever's going around." City jail, city jail. Like an old scared dog, I tucked my tail. I hung my head and not a careless word I said. I gotta sleep on the floor once more, city jail. He said, "No, what I mean is, what are you doing saying things like that to that lady?" And I said, "What's that lady doing with purple hair?" And the badge said, "You're a smart aleck, ain't you, boy?" And I said, "No, sir, I'm just hungry." And he said, "Well, you're acting like a smart aleck." And I said, "Well, that's how I act when I get hungry." City jail, city jail. Like an old scared dog, I tuck my tail. I hung my head and not a careless word I said. I gotta sleep on the floor once more at city jail. Well, he took me outside to a dark corner, and before I could say hypocrite, he hit me on the head, and I said, "Don't hit me on the head, I can't protect myself with these handcuffs on." Then he hit me again, and I said, "Please don't stand on my feet. When you hit me, I'll break my ankles when I fall." City jail, oh city jail. Like an old scared dog, I tuck my tail. I hung my head and not a careless word I said. I gotta sleep on the floor once more at city jail. Well, about the time they threw me in the wagon, that waitress walked out with a sailor and I said, "Hey, you, not you, sailor, I'm talking to the purple people eater. You, lady, quote, you're the cause of it all," unquote. Then she said to the sailor, she said, "Get me away from that horrible man, Harry." And as they hauled me away, I said, "Everybody have a nice evening." City jail, oh city jail. Like an old scared dog, I tucked my tail. I hung my head and not a careless word I said. I gotta sleep on the floor once more at city jail. I gotta sleep on the floor once more at the city jail.
Big John Cash down in the city jail. When someone in our house has a cold or flu and wants relief from the aches and fever, it's rest, fluids, and Bayer aspirin. In my parents' house, it was rest, fluids, Bayer aspirin. In my grandparents' house, it was rest, fluids, Bayer aspirin. Isn't it amazing? In over 60 years, medical science hasn't been able to improve upon aspirin. Three generations of doctors have recommended it. Bayer was the first aspirin, and today Bayer is still number one. Use only as directed. In some parts of the country, Susan, they still see those old ranch party television shows, but they were done many years ago, weren't they?
Yes, they haven't been filmed for almost 5 years, and it's rather embarrassing. A lot of times people will say, "You know, you're a lot smaller than I thought you were," when really I'm the same size I've always been, and I try to explain to them that it's only that they've seen me pregnant for the last 5 years on the reruns. And so, you know, it does get...
Oh, you mean in those...
Well, in a bunch of them I was expecting, and I think it's confusing at times, you know, how many people are expecting for 5 years.
I assume when Hee Haw came along, that sort of, they phased that show out then, didn't they?
I think that was more or less the object behind it, that that they were getting enough exposure with Hee Haw, and why overdo it? However, it didn't exactly work out because they just keep playing the old ones over and over.
Some stations still play the old ones, don't
mm-hmm.
they?
In fact, they just started showing them in Bakersfield at 11 o'clock at night. And I'm going to a Bible study class, and it was really embarrassing one night. They said, "Oh, I saw you on television last night at 11, and, you know, you're wearing boots, you know, the old boots and the short dresses. And, oh, looks terrible.
Oh, yeah, everything tacky. Is out of style.
Yeah.
The songs are old.
Yeah. Songs don't look as old as old clothes,
do. Of course, some of the songs that were standards, I guess, would last forever. But I wanted to point that out. In case you wanted to
that
defend
was
you.
Very...
In case you wanted to defend yourself.
Yes, I think it was good of you.
This little lady was our guest last week on the show, and I, and we both had the flu when we taped the show.
Mm-hmm.
She was getting the flu, and I was about to get over it. And there was a point, and I couldn't hear very well. My head was stopped up. And there was a point in that show where I felt like we were two old, very old men trying to do a show together, you know. And Lynn Anderson looks like anything but a very old
man. I would think so.
She's a very pretty girl, but she came by and brought her daughter, Lisa, who is 6 years old, and we had a good time. We always do. And we were playing this song a lot, her latest record called Wrap Your Love All Around Your Man.
Don't you know this whole world, it can go up and down, but I found love keeps it turning. He is the fire that fuels my desire. A woman's my name on the flame that keeps it burning. It's a fact that it's all but true.
That is Lynn Anderson with an encore from last week. Lynn with Wrap Your Love All Around Your Man. Friends, let me tell you about one of my favorite things. It's the country music newspaper, Music City News, the only major country music publication that comes from Nashville. Every month you get to read exclusive interviews with country music stars, album reviews, new record releases, behind-the-scenes stories, visit the stars' homes, and there are lots of pictures, but very important, something no other country music publication has, Music City News lists when and where you can get to see future personal appearances of the stars. You too can become a part of the country music scene by subscribing to Music City News. Subscribe now by enclosing your check for $8, and you'll be saving more than 20% off the single copy price. And in addition to that, for acting now, you'll get a baker's dozen. That's 13 issues for the price of 12. So rush your check for $8 today to Ralph Emery, Post Office Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. That's Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. Susan Raye is my guest. Susan, what's the most embarrassing thing that ever happened to you in show business? Perhaps besides the streaking incident you mentioned earlier.
Well, I think maybe one of them was a show that we did in Reno, and we were on stage and doing a performance, and have you ever tried to swallow and breathe at the same time?
I never thought about it.
You've never done it?
Swallow and breathe?
You choke.
All right, why were you
sputter?
Okay.
Well, it was accidentally. I didn't do it on purpose. But I was in the middle of a song, and I went to take a breath, and I confused, you know, my mind got confused with my mouth or my throat or whatever, and I swallowed and breathed at the same time, and I immediately sputtered and coughed and choked in the middle of it, you know, right in the middle of the line. You know, it's very embarrassing.
Were you in that big room that's so fancy out there at... Were you at Harris Club?
No, we played the Nugget, John Esquaga's Nugget in Sparks.
But that's a
it's a nice room. It's a
nice room with very a dinner crowd.
Oh yes, people, of course.
People
yes.
in tuxes and
mm-hmm,
so forth.
Of course, I very see. Proper. You know.
There you are going. Yes. Do you ever work outdoors?
It's hard to be cool, you know. Oh, you swallow a bug.
Swallow
yes.
a bug. Mm-hmm.
I've sang where I was afraid to open my mouth. Yes.
Why? Afraid he'd fly back out?
No, there was too many bugs, and I didn't want them in. That was uncalled for, Ralph.
What's the most fun you ever had in show business?
Well, one of the times that I recall is the first trip I ever made to New Zealand.
No, that's not what I'm after here.
What
you
do you mean?
See who's next to sing.
Oh, well, yes.
Susan
now
Raye.
Now that you mention it.
Susan Raye was on our television show along with Lester Roadhog Moran and the Cadillac Cowboy.
None other.
It was hysterical, wasn't it?
Oh. It was awful. You couldn't keep from laughing.
Lester called you Susan Hayes.
What, you know what is so amazing about that act, or is that what you'd call it? Or is it the true, I don't know if it's an act or the true nature of the boys, but most people, when they do a comedy bit, it's like, especially for TV, you know, they do the comedy bit, and then when it's in between takes, you know, everybody stands around with a dull look on their face, and then all of a sudden, when the camera turns back on, then they light back up again. But they were living it. They didn't know how to quit.
They didn't come out of character.
They were hilarious. I mean, you know, the audience and the cameraman and everything. I've never seen anything like it.
Well, we're going to bring them on in their alter ego known as the Statler Brothers. Bill Bosley, Lou DeWitt, Harold, and Donnie Reed.
There's lots of things in this whole world. Fancy cars and pretty girls. It's something I like more than sunny skies. Grandest thing I've ever seen are pictures on a movie screen. Wolfman, you're a fright, all right, but sure a sight for sore eyes. It's a world of kings and queens up there on that movie screen. It's a picnic crossing River Kwai. The movies are great medicine. Thank you, Thomas Edison, for giving us the best years of our lives. Citizen Kane, Kane Mutiny, Mutiny on the Bounty, the Bounty Hunters, the Hunters, and the Sting. Thunder Road and Road to Rio, Rio Grande and Grand Hotel, tell them Willie Boy was here with Bride of Frankenstein and Shane.
I love anything that moves, dancing feet to horses' hooves, Peyton Place to Dorothy's trip to Oz. Tom Mix to David Edison, thank you Thomas Edison for giving us the best years of our lives.
I love Captain Blood and Elmer Fudd and Charlie Chan, Ben-Ben-Hur, the way we were, True Grin and Music Man, Thunderball and Walking Tall and Jaws and Jesse James, Dr. No and Vertigo and Singing in the Rain.
Blood and Sand and Santa Fe, Dunaway and Getaway, Mexicali, Rose and Rosemary, Blackboard Jungle, Jungle Jim, Jim for All American, An American in Paris, Paris Blues, Blue Hawaii.
I'm teaching Bet on Ship of Fools, the movies were my special school. I'm a graduate of 12 o'clock high. The movies are great medicine. I thank you, Tommy Edison, for giving us the best years of our lives.
One flew over the cuckoo's nest. The movies are the craziest. I'll be a movie nut until I die. Movies are great medicine. Thank you, Thomas Edison, for giving us the best years of our lives.
Roy Rogers,
you gave us the best years of our lives.
The Statler Brothers, who love nostalgia, singing the movies. You are listening to the Ralph Emery Show. My guest is...
Susan Raye.
And you are about to sing what?
Put a Little Love in Your Heart.
Think of your fellow man, lend him a helping hand, put a little love in your heart. You see it's getting late, oh please don't hesitate, put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place, and the world will be a better place for you and me. You just wait and see. Another day goes by, and still the children cry. Put a little love in your heart. If we want the world to know, we won't let hatred grow. Put a little love in your heart,
and the world
will be a better place. All the world,
and the world
will be a better place for you,
for you
and me.
And me,
you just wait,
just wait,
wait and see. Take a good look around, and if you're looking down, put a little love in your heart. I hope when you decide, kindness will be a guide. Put a little love in your heart,
and the world
will be a better place.
And the world
will be a better place for you,
for you
and me. You
just wait,
wait and see.
People now,
put a little love in your heart.
Each and every day,
put a little love in your heart.
Don't throw love away,
put a little love in your heart.
You've got to
put a little love in your heart.
That's a nice little tune. Like that too. Da 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 da. Put a little love in your heart. Have a new duet on the show. I assume you know Willie Nelson.
I know Willie. I know of him. I used to sing a lot of his songs, and he used to work around Portland, Oregon, around Vancouver, Washington, right across the river.
When was that?
About 1962, I think, around the 60 to 62.
When he was living in Nashville then.
Was he living in Nashville
then?
Well, maybe it was before then.
Now, Darryl McCall...
I don't know him.
You don't know Darryl?
No.
Darryl, for years, he was the tenor singer with Farron Young and with Ray Price. And he sort of came up in the same, came out of the same mold that Johnny Paycheck came out of. The fact is, they grew up together and they came out of the same hometown in Ohio. And Darryl McCall is out of the Ray Price singing school. He really
sings.
Oh,
yes. Well, I've heard him sing. I just have not met him.
And Darryl records for Willie Nelson's Lone Star Record Company.
Mm-hmm.
So they got together in the studio one day, and this is what happened.
As I hear the mockingbird, I remember your words when you said that you'd forever love me. Now the happiness is gone, and all those heartaches linger on. And from the chains of our love I can't be free.
Sweet as the morning, smile like the sunshine. Ours was a love could tell. I love you. Oh, how I miss you. Won't you come back, Lily Dale? Goodbye, I'm so blue,
I cry. Happiness is a thing of past. Days without you make my night so blue, and always in my heart our love will last.
Sweet as the morning, smile like the sunshine. Ours was a love no words could tell. I love you, oh how I miss you. Won't you come back, Lily Day? Come back, Lily Dale.
Another combination. Darryl McCall singing with Willie Nelson, an old Bob Wills song called Lily Dale.
Now a message from Sunrise 6 Productions.
The superstars of country music, 20 of the very best of the million sellers, such stars as Roy Clark.
Yesterday, when I was young, the taste of life was sweet as rain upon
Mickey Gilley.
The orchid is a flower that blooms so tenderly.
Johnny Rodriguez.
Honey, I love you too. That's the way love goes.
Tom T. Hall.
I love little country.
And Donna Fargo. You'll get the Statler Brothers, Dave Dudley, Sammy Smith, Narvel Feltz, and Hank Thompson. 20 superstar artists in all. And to order yours, send $4.95 to Country Lovin', Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee, 37202.
When someone in our house has a cold or flu and wants relief from the aches and fever, it's rest, fluids, and Bayer aspirin. In my parents' house, it was rest, fluids, Bayer aspirin. In my grandparents' house, it was rest, fluids, Bayer aspirin. Isn't it amazing? In over 60 years, medical science hasn't been able to improve upon aspirin. Three generations of doctors have recommended it. Bayer was the first aspirin, and today Bayer is still number one. Use only as directed.
We are nearing the end of our little visit with Susan Raye. Susan, you used to work with Freddie Hart a lot, didn't you?
I worked with him in Las Vegas years ago.
And, of course, wasn't he in the Buck Owens camp, as they used to say?
Well, he was for a while. When I worked with him, it was a different thing. It was before I went to work with Buck Owens, as a matter of fact.
Oh, really?
Uh-huh.
I always assumed Buck Owens discovered you and got you into show business.
Well, he did. I had known Buck for 3 or 4 years before I actually went to work with him. So I had done some tours with Buck, but Freddie Hart had also come up to Portland where I was singing.
Were you a local Portland, Oregon singer?
Right. And he worked in a club that I worked at, and he needed a band to go to Vegas with him, and the band that I worked with was very good, and he asked them to go, and then he said if he could pay me extra, would I go with them? So I went with him, and I worked with Freddie for a couple of weeks, I think, in Las Vegas, and then it was the last night, our closing night in Vegas, that I got a phone call from Buck Owens, and he asked me to come through, and I decided to go to work with his roadshow then.
Did Freddie Hart, when you worked with him, ever... I bring this up because when Freddie was on this show, he tried to give women some advice on self-defense, what to do in case you need to defend yourself. I wondered if he ever gave you any advice of that sort.
No, he sure didn't.
You know, he is a judo and karate expert.
I remember one night in a tour in Boston, Massachusetts, when Freddie, a young man, thought he was real cool, and he'd probably had a couple of drinks or two, I would imagine, or he'd have known better, and he wanted to arm wrestle with Freddie, and he kept insisting, and Freddie kept trying to say, oh no, son, you know, you don't want to, and he finally did, and he came away with a gold ring that was just, it was just all, you know, you couldn't, it wasn't round anymore.
Oh, you mean they did arm wrestle?
Mm-hmm. And he finally couldn't get him to quit, so but he walked away and his ring was all out of shape.
Freddie mashed his ring all out of shape.
All bent out of shape.
Oh, wow. You ever been all bent out of shape?
No, not like that.
Here is the sensational Emmy Lou Harris.
You could see that Pierre did truly love the mademoiselle. Now the younger sir and madame had rung the chapel bell. C'est la vie, say the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell. The furnished off an apartment with a two-room robot sale.
Emmy Lou Harris with the fiddles raging there and the old Chuck Berry lyric singing C'est la vie. Now, why don't we play an oldie, Susan?
Why don't we?
Okay.
I think that would be a good idea, and it just so happens that we have one laying around for just such an occasion. This is one of Glenn Campbell's oldies.
Galveston, I still hear your sea winds blowing. I still see her dark eyes glowing. She was 21 when I left Galveston. Galveston, oh Galveston, I still hear your sea waves crashing while I watch the cannons splashing. I clean my gun and dream of Galveston. I still see her standing by the water, looking out to sea. And is she waiting there for me on the beach where we to run. Galveston, oh Galveston, I am so afraid of dying. Before I dry the tears she's crying, before I watch your seabirds flying in the sun at Galveston, at Galveston.
This came along about the time Glenn was so hot with, well, a Wichita lineman. By the time I get to
Phoenix, he was big on towns then.
Yeah, he really was. And he had a, what he did a song called Houston.
I think if he'd have just stayed with that, he could have, you know, he could have been around for years, just covering everybody.
Glenn Campbell, I guess from about, I'm going to guess, 1969, 1970, right in there. Glenn with Galveston.
Here's Merle Haggard and big news about Ford pickup gas mileage.
Hey, pickup driving man, are you in luck? Ford's got your kind of a real tough truck. It's a strong running, long running, smooth as a song running pickup with a proud Ford brand. Made tough for the pickup driving man.
Whatever you pick, you've got yourself one tough truck when you own a Ford F-150. Just how tough? Well, 93 out of 100 of all Ford trucks registered over the last 12 years are still on the job. Compared to our nearest competitor, a higher percentage of Ford trucks are still out there running after 12 years, 13, 14, even after 15 years. So get yourself down to your Ford dealer and check out that F-150.
We are about to conclude our visit with Susan Raye. Susan, I assume that you will go home to California tomorrow?
I'm going home for a day or two, and then I'm going to pack up and take my little ones to Reno with me.
And you'll be appearing there for how long?
1 week.
Susan, will you be seen throughout 1977 at doing one-nighters in auditoriums, places like that?
Right. I usually do a lot of fairs in the summertime, and I'll be doing a lot of shows throughout the country in auditoriums, whatever.
I assume as a single act.
Mm-hmm.
And not with the Buck Owens package.
I don't believe so. I haven't been working with Buck.
All right. I want to conclude our little visit by playing your latest record for all these folks again. It's called Mr. Heartache.
Nothing left but wrinkles in the bed where you slept. Not even a note to say goodbye. It's just like waking up in the middle of a bad dream. But dreams don't break your heart and make you cry. myself another cup of coffee.
That's our guest star of the week, Susan Raye, who has been a delight to spend time with. And Susan, I hope your new album comes out just terrifically.
Thank you. I hope it does too.
Susan Raye singing Mr. Heartache. Now we're going to leave you, my friend. We thank you so much for joining us for our visit with Susan Raye, and we'll rejoin you with another top country music star next week. All brought your way by Ford Trucks and by Bayer Aspirin for the final time. Goodbye, Susan.
Goodbye, Ralph.